Hello and welcome back to another Wartales adventure. My name is Syken and today we're answering the questions, can you survive in Wartales with only animal companions? We're playing on expert difficulty with a region lock, and today is going to be the day where we are doing the death march. So the idea is we have gathered a couple of animal companions, whatever we could find. We got Ötzi the snow creeper, who is not really an animal companion but our beloved and trusted friend. We got a dragon from the new DLC, who is going to hopefully be a fun addition. We got a white polar bear, we got a boar, we got a wolf, and we got one archer to control that herding of cats disaster that's going to unfold. The rules of the game will be that we will, let's give ourselves a couple of names, Wolfgang the Wolf, Boris the Boar, and Walter the White Bear, and I think the dragon is supposed to be called Doug, Doug the Dragon. Good, makes it a little bit more personal. Whilst the rules of the game are the following. We win if we can make it from Arthas through all of the different counties, which means Arthas into Tiltren, into Altres, all the way up to Ludern, Veltres, Grinmer, and then finally Dronbach. The second rule of the game is there is not going to be any avoiding of combat whatsoever. So if we're running into something, it needs to be fought. Luckily, our wanted rating currently is low, but that might change over time. Who knows? And yeah, I think short of Louis the Lizard, a siren that I recently caught and enslaved, I think everybody else is actually doing reasonably well. So we're going to see how well this is going to play out. In terms of camp, nah. Louis, you continue to stay here. I'm sorry, you can't be trusted. Anyways, back to the actual action. I'll fast forward a lot and give you an update where we are. We are going to win if the majority of characters makes it. So currently we're looking at 3, 8, 7 characters. So at least 4 of them need to survive in order for this challenge to be successful. There might be losses on the way. End of day 1, and we are going to camp right at the border of Tiltren. Let's take a good look at another challenge part of this run, which is surviving with a limited amount of food. The problem is bears are eating just an enormous amount of food, and we have not a lot of options to actually gather new food. So it's going to be interesting how low morale will affect the later stages of the death march. For now, we've made our way into Tiltren, and this is still child's play, easy parts. It'll become more difficult once we're entering the swamps of Lutren. For now, we are still cruising. Not too long until we are running into our first encounter in Tiltren. This should still be an easy one. Keep in mind, we are playing on region locked. There should be not much opposition, but this is a great opportunity, now that we do have it, in order to gather some food. Since boars are known to produce quite a bit of that. So, not much is happening here other than us slaughtering them. But it's still worthwhile, because we're going to get a lot of meat from it. These guys stand no chance, they are way too underleveled. But they have tasty, tasty components. 3 meat, that might be the one way of how we're going to survive this run, by regularly running into boars. However, I can assure you that after Tiltren, it's not going to be that easy anymore. End of day 2, and we are at the very border between Tiltren and the infamous Mount Altus, which is an independent secret state that you may or may not know when you have played the legend, the Arena of Legends here. Time for another short break, as our heroes need to feast. And let's get on with the journey. We have just passed the border to Ludern, and that is where the real part of this run is going to unfortunately start, as we're not allowed to avoid any of the fights. And Ludern is infamous for a lot of infighting. Everything hates you and others. Let's just hope we're not going to run into something too strong. I think the first fight is going to be against the mosquitoes, so let's go. Good, since these guys are also creatures, I don't foresee a lot of problems happening. They are animals just like most of our guys, and typically animals aren't that great. Good, we're picking a tight formation, and low-level animals really can be easily manipulated. Yep. Very good. That, again, should still be a relatively clear victory for us. Not going to use a lot of Valor points, because we frankly also don't have a great way of restoring them. Just out of curiosity, what is this here? Armageddon bomb? Oh, okay, yeah, we don't want to step onto an Armageddon bomb. Okay, let's fast forward a bit. Good, end of round one, and we have killed a lot of them. We do have two flanks. There is the left side, where three mosquitoes are coming, and one poisonous cloud. But Doug the Dragon, naturally as a dragon, is immune to all poison, which is great. So I think we can clean up most of this. Easy. Wow, dragons are so good. So, that was a fun little encounter. But unfortunately, it's back to back here. Time for the Crocs one. This might be a little bit harder. What are we talking about? Level 8 Crocs wines. Well, I guess we can. That's still going to work out in our favor. Quite a few of them. So let's start with our usual barrage. Our main advantage against animals is they also don't have a lot of armor, so we should be reasonably safe. Doug is going to hold the one flank by himself. And we've dealt so much damage that the game is offering us a bit of a concession with galvanizing. Yeah, the Croxwines aren't strong enough by themselves, but make no mistake, we're going to run into human enemies, and the moment that that happens, things are going to look very, very, very different.
Thank you.
Good. Ötzi moves forward. I want to get maximum traction out of his frost breath. Well, 17 isn't great. The frost breath of the snow creepers is actually quite good if you do have a lot of snow creepers, that is, because all of a sudden you can wiggle even strong enemies down. Granted, you're going to lose a lot of frost creepers in the process, but it deals percentage damage of their hit points, and so that's actually not too bad. Wolfgang is going to help out on the southern flank. Are reinforcements incoming? Oh, so close to galvanization, and now reinforcements are incoming. Oh. And a lot of them. Alright. Duck the dragon very nicely kills most of the front line before moving to become even more tanky. This southern front line looks a bit in trouble, but we do have northerners coming in as well. One croc swine dies. We're moving up. And the frost breath does not kill the second one. Gotta help the southern the southern end here. Alright, that's good. More croc swines are coming in from the north, but the mud nicely prevents them from coming this round. Unfortunately for us, Walter is poisoned, so he's going to take a lot of poison damage. Yeah, but overall we're doing fine, I guess. Finally. Good. Tough one. We got a bit of croc swine meat. That should be enough in order to feed us for the next few days. So, well, not potentially just for one day. So we're going to move on, but that was the first real encounter for us. Fast forward, end of day 3. We find ourselves almost at the northern section in Ludern. It is time to empty the food bank once again. And rest a little bit. Fabulous. Well, that's a good question. What are we going to do? I think you're going to get yourself a little bit of experience yourself. Maybe we can even level up the archer. Who knows? All right, moving on to the northern part of Ludern, where the biggest problem is how to get back without running into a lot of patrols. So far it was surprisingly quiet here. We haven't even seen a single camp of bandits. Let's check that area and then we're doing a turnaround. Yep, there is a camp of bandits. I knew it. I was about to say there are always bandits up here. So, according to our rules, that means we need to fight, and reinforcements are incoming. That will be a little bit tougher than the battle before. So what are we dealing with? A couple of wrongdoers, which unfortunately do have a lot of critical damage. And there is a second pack of wrongdoers on the other side. We are going to leave them alone and we will focus on this side here exclusively. Yep, that's going to hurt. I can already see it. All right, moving in. And we're engaging with the first wrongdoer. Water is going to tank for us. And he's going to do that very, very well. Just need to make sure that Walter doesn't get too many poison stacks, because that's the only thing that could mess the whole thing, the whole setup up. Enemy rogue tries to poison us, but little does he know that Duck is immune to poisoning. And the lizards also have a nasty reflection ability where whenever you hit them in melee, they are going to make you bleed, which in itself is already a problem. Okay, I think what we're going to do here is we're spending a Veiler. Unfortunately, that was not good enough. Good question. Should we try to hit these guys? You know, why not? Let's just get the poacher out of the way. Good, that was our once a encounter super attack. And unfortunately, from now on, we're not having such great opportunities anymore. We do have a Marauder, one that might wreak havoc if we let him into the back line. So we're going to engage with them. And thanks to Frost Breath, he's even taking some extra damage. Unfortunately, I think Ötzi will deeply regret that. Yep, figured that would be the case. But we can focus on this guy and start getting him down. Power numbers, whilst the other side of the enemy is running into us. Keep in mind, these are still moderate difficult enemies because they are region locked. It will become much more difficult in the later parts of this run. There needs to be a little bit of tension over time. Alright, let's fast forward a bit as we're coming into a nice little stalemate. Oh no, wait a second. Let's maybe not. Let's see what the reinforcements are going to look like. Got a pugilist, a rogue, and a two-handed executioner. Another poacher down there. Oh boy. That's going to hurt. Well, the good news is we can use the environment to our advantage. Nope. There is no good news. Animals can't use it. So Walter is still tanking. And I'm thinking we need to eliminate these guys whilst Walter is still taking care of both of the harder targets. Let's see, Hodlum. Yep, nice hit. And we're going to go back. I'm trying to be mindful not to spend too many Valor points. Alright, Boris is going to be the one that is going to engage the pugilist. Moving up. Attack from behind. Oh, that was a fantastic one. Wolfgang, you're the best. One thing that is working with wolves just fabulously, they are super, super sturdy. Once they attack, enemies just drop dead. Good. I think we can wrap this one up. It looks like we're cleaning up the rest. So, it indeed has been a wrap. Let's loot what we can and appreciate that we have just beaten our first human opponents. Granted, they were level 8, so nothing to write home about, but you can see how it's going to become more and more difficult, specifically since humans can carry armor. So, our journey will now lead us through the Vertruz province and then all the way into Grinmer. Kind of a nice little walk around here, and then finally the Drombach area. I would say we're going to finalize the run kind of up here, if we ever make it that deep into Drombach. But before that's the case, we are being greeted by more mosquitoes. I'll fast forward that. After a couple of mosquitoes, the worst of the worst is coming true. I was hoping that we will not encounter the March of the Dead, but we indeed are. So, might as well do it. Let's go, boys. Good, we find ourselves fighting against the zombies, and the biggest problem here is it's one of those maps where you actually need to flee. So, anyone who is staying behind, that's a really bad idea, as we will need to run, and we will need to run fast and very, very furious. So let's start by taking all of you. Get a couple more temporary Valor points. One of which we are spending to get to here. Alright, so the name of the game here is just try to evacuate yourself. Don't play the hero. Hashtag just get out of here. Moves in. Couldn't quite finish him. Unfortunate. One thing that I learned about the plague ridden is they are so plentiful, there is just no great way of getting all of them down. Very well. Good. Walter is hopefully going to tank all of that. But the problem is also stacking poison. And now Ötzi has a plague infected wound. Well, that will suck for the rest of this run. That's very unfortunate for us. Nah, I'm not going to use unstoppable charge yet. Let's just hope we're not getting bogged down with them fighting us. What we want is to get out of here as fast as possible. And that includes needing to be able to kill all of them. Next turn, hopefully everybody can just get out of here. Because, yep, that's exactly what's going to happen. More of them are coming in. Duck begins to lead the charge. We can't flee because we have attacked during this round, which means Duck needs to survive one more round engaged and behind enemy lines. Uh-oh. Well, let's hope Walter can help him. Good. Walter moves in. And I would say the kind of weaker targets can already make their exit. Betsy, in that case, makes a run for it. Boris can charge and move out of here, so we're not in a bad position. Unstoppable charge allows you to disengage without attacks of opportunity. And Boris has indeed successfully fled. Now let's see what Wolfgang is going to do. Flees as well. Only the little bit stronger, tougher animal companions are left. Nice little hit that kills one of them. And we got a second one down. Cool. That is as much as we could ask for. And now the question is going to hold? Are we getting out of here? I think our advantage is that the Losts themselves, I call them the Losts, they are the Plague Ones. The Plague Ones themselves are disorganized, so we potentially should hold. I'll fast forward and tell you if anything happens. Good, next turn. We definitely need to flee from here. Disengage, take the beating, and just flee the battle. Thank you. Unfortunately for us, the last person to leave needs to be our ranger, because elsewise the animal companions will no longer be controlled, and as such they would just go rampage, and I don't want to lose Walter. That would be a pity, but luckily for us, I've saved a couple of points and we are able to disengage and flee. Much closer than I would have anticipated. Got a couple of wounds. Ötzi here is plague infected, but we can cure that, so we're good. For my own sanity, we're not going to run into all of them at the same time. Let's get the swines and fast forward. Wow, about 2 hours into the run, and we have had plenty of combat. Matter of fact, more than I would have anticipated, but the team is holding up very well, even better than I would have anticipated originally, with our new with our newfound team, we can even appoint a lieutenant. And who would be a better lieutenant than Wolfgang? There you go. Lieutenant Wolfgang. Now gets tactical orders. Not sure how that is going to look like when a wolf is telling you what to do. But it's good. I like it. So, we're making our way out of Ludern, hopefully. And next up, we are going to see Vertruz, the Vertruz province. Finally, you know what the best part about the Ludern region is? Leaving the Ludern region. Whenever I'm there, it feels like a good moment in time to leave. It's just incredibly hostile, and yeah, I'm very happy that we've made it that far. We are in Vertruz, and next stop will be the Grinmer province. I think Vertruz itself shouldn't be too difficult because we're playing region locked, so this here is, I think, level 4 or 5. Can't imagine that anything is going to majorly disrupt us, but you never should be too confident in your abilities. There might be a couple of bandits of high level roaming around. So, let's hope that's not going to happen. Night number 5, and we're not even across the border. You can see how our food supply is slowly but surely dwindling. But morale is high, and we have done well so far. Let's go, boys. Time for the Gosenberg border crossing. Like I said, Vertruz wasn't really very eventful. But Gosenberg might be, and there is quite a bit to do in Gosenberg. And according to our own rules, we need to do a full circle here. And would you know it, also according to our own rules, we stumbled upon a rat nest. We can't let that the rat infestation be. So it's time to earn our reward here. Good, for obvious reasons, I think we're just going to focus on the rat mother instead of actually getting additional plague columns down. But I might be wrong. What are we looking at? 66 points of damage? That's not great. Let's get the rat mother. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Very nice. Walter is going in. The rats are not doing a lot of damage, but they are ultra annoying. Let's hope we can get the brood mother down ASAP. It shouldn't be too difficult. I'm just realizing if the enemies are so low on hit points, there isn't much that they can do in order to oppose you. There we go. We made quick work of it. In case you're wondering, oh man, Syken, why would you not do more? I want to win the challenge. I don't need pristine essences anymore. I do have plenty of them. All right, moving on. Let's continue our walk through the Grinmer province. And I've just spotted our first real challenge. We are running into bandits. Please, don't let it be... Okay, level 9, that's fine. That is actually fine. So, what could be an advantage for us is that the city maps tend to be ultra big. So, choose one side, overload it, and profit. That's the idea. Leave the other side alone, and what are we going to do? I think Walter is moving in. nice hit and is immediately starting to kill one of them. Immobilizes these two guys. Fantastic. So they can't move further. We're having access to their back line. The poacher needs to be... Oh, I was set bound into melee, but just killing him is equally an option. Nothing wrong with that. We're staying just a bit away from the scoundrel so that they will deal with Walter, saving Duck a couple of hit points. The criminal is AoE attacking, so we don't want that. But what we could do is bind him into melee. Ötzi moves in. Oh, nice. Good hit. Surround for some extra damage. And the pugilist is regretting his life choices. Get a crit in return. These guys are almost on an equal level. Not quite. Level 9. Getting harder, but not yet on our level. So we still have the level advantage. Getting a couple of Valor points to play with. Oh yeah. Good. It's not... It is more one-sided than I would have thought. It's not as difficult as I thought it would be at the beginning of the fight. But as always, I've spoken too early, too soon, as we are seeing reinforcements, 4 of them. Oh, not good. Let's spend one of our points to be really, really quick, because I want to bind these guys into melee. Hodlum dies. And let's make sure you cannot move, which means everybody else will run into Walter, who's hopefully going to tank this like a boss. Moving up. I think we're fine. We don't need to spend an extra point for just a little bit of damage. Wolfgang moves up. Nice hit. Hit the Marauder. Oh, hit him good. I like that. And if we position ourselves here... let's position ourselves up there. Fantastic. Wolfgang... Boris, I meant to say, is just moving up. Unfortunately, Walter is taking some decisive damage and is now starting to bleed. Don't want to be in the front line with the wrong door. So we're just going to hide behind the tank for now. The fight is closer than I anticipated. It's swinging from we're giving them a harder time than anticipated into it's closer than anticipated, specifically because they still do have more reinforcements coming. Alright. Getting the scoundrel down. Big thing for us. And we are just going to block over here. Wolfgang moves up, attacks the wrong door from behind. Unfortunately, poisons himself in the process. At least all of the reinforcements have now arrived. Taking the wrong door. And destabilizing him for one round. That will take the guard off of him, which is going to be important. Yeah, enemies finally catch up, so we need to protect that other flank. But before we're doing that, let's see three attacks against the wrong door. Wow, 490. That was awesome. Very good. And whilst we're at it, might as well heal the four poison, which really stinks for Walter. Oh, we do have more enemies over here. Oh gosh, we can't even reach them. Good, making sure that that marauder doesn't attack multiples in melee. You know what? I think you can throw, right? No, you cannot. Oh, that's so disappointing. Take from behind. I think the axe, well, it depends. No, he has obliteration. I don't want to stand near him. We're moving a little bit further out of his range. Good. Duck is needing to tank the aggression up here. That's a lot of damage. Oh yeah. Duck is in a world of pain. That's a big problem. Let's start by keeping that flank safe and secure. The only person who can actually throw the spear is our archer. And we're going to use as much damage as possible just to make sure that we're getting that galvanization. We're okay. For now. Good. Wolfgang does what he does best. Attack the back line. Snack the back line. And we're good. Another quick kill. Just trying to thin out the enemy, really. Oh yeah, baby. Galvanization was our friend. Okay, that was closer, as you can see. Progressively, the battles are getting more and more difficult. But we are holding our own. So far, so good. We're still staying strong. Night rest number 7. And we see that the food is very much dwindling. We're down to just a few reserves. And we still have a way to go. We can appoint a second lieutenant. That's not a bad thing. How about Walter the Bear? There you go. Damage against plague-infested outgrowth increases by 50%. Sure, why not? Alright, let's continue to move. A little bit later this day, we are running into pitchforking peasants that seem to just hate it here.
Did you see those beautiful crops? I don't see why we should stop. We can have fun in our own fields, can't we? No. Please don't harm us.
Intimidated by a band of nobodies. Unfortunately, we are now at 80 wanted. That is a problem. Like I said, maybe it's going to be a bit more difficult. Let's hope we're not running into any patrols. Night number 8, and we're camping out in the wilderness. Oh boy. Food is getting very, very sparse, so soon we won't be able to keep the high morale. Good. We finally are back in the Vertruz province. On the upside, we have almost lost our wanted status, which is great because I think we wouldn't have been able to stand a chance against the guards, and it would have been a real pity if the run ends right here. Good. Next, we're going to go to the final chapter. Time to make our way to Drombak, and hopefully Drombak country will be survived. So far, we're doing well, but the most difficult part is still ahead of us. Night number 9, and I think this is the time where the food will finally run out. We could collect a few mushrooms, but that's about it. Nah, we're still good, maybe for one more night. Maybe this is going to hold, who knows. Oh, we can get aptitude points, fantastic. Not that it will make a huge difference, but that's not bad. Finally, after days of journey, we crossed the Drombak County border. And this is where the adventure will take a turn to its worst, because now we're in a territory where things are not going according to plan. This is the high-level area that might challenge us. Beautiful mountain landscape in Drombak. Luckily for us, no wildlife so far. Night number 10. And this is where things are taking a turn for the worst, because now we're running out of food. We're camping right under the mountain ridges of Drombak, so here we are. Still need to go all the way through here and end our run there. The most difficult part is ahead of us. And would you have known it, we are running into a couple of wolves, this time level 12. So we have finally found a proper match for us. Well, let's see if we can get them down quick enough so that the reinforcements are not going to appear. Most specifically, we want to get that alpha wolf down. Has a lot of hit points because they are level 12, so no easy picking for us. Enemies of a similar level typically cannot one-shot each other, and since most of our characters are around that level, between 10 and 12, we of course cannot just kill them. Okay, galvanization. I'm just trying my very best to deal as much upfront damage as possible. I'm hoping that we can end the encounter before it even starts. Very good. Easy pickings on that one. And we got a little bit of food out of it, which isn't too bad. Shouldn't leave the mushrooms behind. Good. Now the difficult part. Oh, well, the difficult part immediately appeared in the form of a couple of bears. Oh boy, five bears, holy. Alright, so a couple of thoughts around the bears. We are having a bit of a problem here. Bears are high hit point targets. We're looking at 2,000 hit points. That's just as much as Walter is having. So it doesn't take a genius to understand that these five bears in a direct confrontation will pretty much wipe the floor with us. They are dealing a lot of damage, almost too much. And we will need to find a way around that. My best bet would be to actually start using poison in some shape or form. So this here would be a good position for Walter. He's not necessarily going to sacrifice himself, but we will need a way for him to get in. Walter also gives tactical order to our archer, because we will need a lot of valor points to go through that. Then we got fragility onto all of them. Oh no, it's not AoE. Well, okay. Well, we're focusing on one of them. This bear here first. And we're building up rage. Well, in return, as you can imagine, they are hitting as well, and they are hitting very hard. Good, we're moving up. Tail slash should not get us into combat, but poisons them, which is ultra helpful. That's exactly what we're looking for. Another bite from the back. Poison will deal a lot of damage against them, so whenever possible we're going to use it to our advantage. Uh-oh. Look, Walter needs protection. Can Wolfgang realistically survive a single hit from the bear? I don't know. I don't know. Well, with deflection he can, so we're going to make sure that we can tank one bite. The bleeding should be very nice because it deals extra damage. Let's end Wolfgang's turn. We're focusing our attacks on that surrounded bear. Ooh. Boros is taking too much damage here. Archer needs to be the one who is taking a hit. Damage onto every single one and slows them down. Get a full attack. Nice, very nice. Okay, that's good. And we're healing Boris so much so that he can at least absorb one hit. Yep, our archer can't take a lot of hits either, so that's not really an option. This bear here is our secondary target. Not great, but okay. The frost breath deals a lot of damage because they have so many hit points. Alright, new round is starting. This flank here is failing. We need to find a way to deal with it. Moving up here. We need Vela points, and there they are. Very nice. Down to 33 hit points, and I think that is a kill. Cool. Healing Boris further. End of turn. Nice. The deflection really worked well. I think the wolf can tank with deflection. Damage taken, very low. Nice. We need to help this flank over here. The boar isn't doing very well. Let's take over that enemy. Oh yeah, oh yeah, we're doing well. With a build up of rage, we are now... Walter is now dealing a lot of damage. Okay, let's focus on the bear up here. Next. Taking him from behind. Unfortunately, not a crit. Moving to here. Frost breath. Another 300. That's good. That's good. Walter is still standing strong. And as long as we can keep Walter, we are fine. I would move over. Boris didn't do that well against the bears. Not a surprise, they are much stronger than the boar. Ooh, wow. Well, that's not good. Alright, we need deflection for the next attack. Can't disengage because that would mean we're going to die immediately. Good hit. Weakens them. Followed by a poison, which will deal extra damage, and Doug is helping Wolfgang. Will Wolfgang survive? That's the question. Southern flank with Walter still stays strong. You know, I think Wolfgang can survive. I think he can. More poison. Oh yeah, Walter is taking a huge beating, fighting against two bears all by himself. Good, Boris is healed all the way back to full. In the meantime, let's attack and use Frost Breath. This time, Ötzi is going to tank. They are rotating the aggro. And let's give Ötzi protection. There you go, supported. Ouch. Walter is taking such a massive amount of abuse down here. Uh-oh. Gotta be careful not to lose Walter. Healing him. Then this guy needs to be attacked multiple times. Nice. Oh, we do have the option to just acquire them. I think that would be cheating. We need to beat them fair and square. Down to 130. I think that will not be enough to kill them. No. Alright, Walter heals a little bit more. It's back to 500. Has 32 rage stacks and unfortunately takes more damage as well. The opposing bear is down to basically his berserker state. Walter continues to heal. Thankfully we have the healing collar. We do have the ability of our archer to heal. That's a solid kill. Oh yeah, we're doing it. We're getting these bears down. Yeah, sure. All right, tough battle. But we got some food out of it, so That one was a little bit more iffy, but we're still staying strong. The more difficult ones are going to follow up here. And just as we come into the northern region, a massive pack of snow creepers with reinforcements is going to come. This might be it, guys. Snow creepers counter Walter very well due to their ice breath. I'm not sure if we will have the DPS to kill them. Okay, so this is going to be a bit problematic. We do have a bunch of them over here and a bunch of them over there. The problem with all of them is they do have their stupid little frost breath. And frost breath, if you're unaware, the icy breath will give them the ability at the end of their turn to deal 15% of the max hit point of the target. For someone like Walter, that's a lot of hit points that they are going to get off of him, right? So that's a bit of a problem. Walter lets us become orderly and then is going to charge in. Let's stand here so that the fog is gone, because their second ability is they get brutality once they are in the fog, which means damage is increased, but outside of the fog they do have fragility, which is fantastic. That's exactly what we want to see. 30% more damage that they are taking. Mind you, all of them are level 14, so they out-level us heavily. This is potentially going to be our last stand. Oh boy, so much damage. I don't think the duck can keep that flank all by themselves. We need to slow them down, although that I know farewell that I would have loved to save that ability for later stage. Six additional Valor points, thank you. Healing Duck a little bit. And on the other side, we need to kill that Snow Creeper. Thank you. That was a good one. Good hit. Can we kill it? Oh yeah, we can. Alright, the archer comes in clutch and heals on both sides. Which was needed, because Doug is now going into willpower mode, right? Yeah. Yeah, they are taking a lot of damage as well. Dazed means we could disengage. Dazed means we could disengage. Sure, let's do that. Moving a little bit further to the back. This here is a nice spot for us to take a stand, because they are blocking each other very well. Wolfgang is not the perfect person to do that. But he can tank a little bit with deflection. At least a hit or two. Alright, if we make it difficult for them to come through, that'll be perfect. We just need to stall. I don't think... Oh wow, they have two rounds of reinforcements. Just realizing how bad that is. Yeah, let's just keep the front line there. And that's the big problem with their ability. We're just being outmaneuvered with too many attacks from their side. Luckily, the frost breath deals a little bit of damage to them as well. We got them nicely cornered here. As long as we can keep that front line, we're okay. Now the problem is, new reinforcements are going to come in. Oh boy. How do we go about that? Boris just fled the battlefield. That's not good. Let's kill this creeper. Got a heal. And unfortunately, I'm not seeing a lot of options here. We're drawing blank with our options. This front line is going to fall sooner or later. Yeah, we're barely at 13 hit points. That's not even enough to take a lot of hits. Oh yeah, Wolfgang is going to go down. Protective collar is gone. Heals himself with his carnivore ability, where he regains 50% of his hit points once he kills an enemy. Once he strikes an enemy, but I don't think that we can stay here. That would be quite suicidal. That flank is going down. Oh boy. It's not looking good. Ah, they got dug. I knew it would happen eventually. Good. Disconnect, because otherwise we're not going to make it. That is putting fragility on them. Yeah. Okay, let's see if we can one-shot him. No. No. Down to just a little bit, but Walter might go down. Wolfgang took reduced damage, and thankfully he doesn't have that many hit points, so he will live to fight another day. There is the willpower. And Walter went down. That's GG. That is GG. We didn't make it at the end. The snow creepers were too much for us. We needed to flee cowardless, and lost a couple of good companions in return. Dark and Walter will not be forgotten. Boris fled the battle like a pig. And Wolfgang somehow made it out with us. So, the answer to can you survive in Wartales with a hardcore party of just animal companions is potentially no. We were so close. The Drombuck region made it all the way to here. All we had to do was move around here and then move in. I was hoping that we wouldn't run into snow creepers, but running into level 14 snow creepers with 2x reinforcements, that's just nasty. Yeah, well, that unfortunately killed the run. I think we could have gotten through it even with polar bears on level 14, because we did have poison from Doug, which I appreciated. That was good and could deal a lot of damage, but the problem with the Frost Keepers is they just had power in numbers, and we fought like 10 on the first screen, and then another 4 or so were coming in. So just too much for a small group like ours. Unfortunately, you need a little bit of a bigger group with more oomph. The one ill-equipped archer couldn't carry it. Anyways, if you like the challenge run, if you have ideas for other Wartales adventures, let me know in the comments down below. I would love to hear what you come up with, and maybe I could play one or the other interesting further adventure. Thanks a lot for watching, guys, and see you in the next episode. Bye-bye.